JLUP is a very diverse organization, not just academically, but socially. And that's one of our main appeals, is we want to foster a diverse group of people. And one of the things that we, JLUP, I think does differently than other journals is we try to look at the big picture and see, you know, what can this student really bring to the table. And we want students that will be assets for this journal, not just for their time while they're here for that 1 year, but assets, you know, 10 years, 20 years down the road, they'll still be connected to the JLUP organization.
The first advantage is the same advantage that exists for service on any journal, which is that it demonstrates a certain level of achievement for a law student that helps that law student stand out from the crowd. They're recognized in their school as embodying the qualities that law school wishes that everybody had. So it's good for the student through their career. Beyond that, it provides also the same kind of valuable experience in writing and in editing that service on any journal provides. But beyond that, because of the blended format, it provides a series of opportunities and a kind of training that is really unique to JLUP.
The Rutgers Journal of Law and Public Policy is young, and the advantage to that is if you have an idea for a symposium, an article, or an author you'd like to see published, it can happen. The executive board is open to your ideas, and that's the advantage of being a young journal. There's opportunity, there's flexibility, and if you want to be a member of an organization where you can initiate real change, this is the place for you.
One of the greatest benefits of having that flexibility and being a new journal and always experimenting and kind of changing our mold as, you know, as necessary, what it really allows us to do is utilize the talents of all of the staff members. If you have a certain person who has, you know, a certain affinity for business development or marketing or technology in a specific way, we have in the past and we will continue in the future to create positions that create a board which eventually utilizes to the fullest extent everyone's full talents. And continuing along that line of flexibility, in terms of what we publish and the broad area, you know, because law and public policy is a broad area, it's the intersection really of law and the social sciences, so you get the exposure to experts in a variety of fields, whatever you might be interested in. You have the opportunity, like you said, to see Congressman Andrews or to get involved with a politician on a certain issue or a professor who's, you know, proficient in the status of pets as property or something like that, and you really can get into whatever niche you're looking for and get the exposure and get that networking connection to continue for your future.
JLUP is a great opportunity to create that network with our alumni within the journal, but also meeting people who are not from Rutgers through these various symposiums, through speaking engagements that we have on campus.
Being on any journal is really important for your future success, especially when you go to interview at OCI. That's what the employers look for. That's what the best law firms want to see. They want to see journal experience. I know that a lot of the members of our current journal were able to achieve and were able to obtain great summer positions purely or in part because of their membership in JLUP. We had one of the former editor-in-chiefs come back and interview candidates, and obviously he was a little biased in favor of people that are on his journal. And it helped me out tremendously, and I know it helped a lot of the other members as well.
We're one of the first in the first probably in the country to create a blended medium booklet, which is basically the, show you here, it's the abbreviated version of a full bound journal that has the article abstracts and then a CD in the back, which has the full articles on it. So it's a really useful tool for doing research, because when you, these days, most research is done electronically. So if you're looking for certain information, you can pop the CD in, control F, find anything in the articles.
It was, I thought, a terrific idea to come up with a way of having a hard copy journal that would be on library shelves, while at the same time having the text principally available online. So I think it's a wonderful idea that scholars like, and that I think other journals will probably adopt in the future. I don't know if there are others yet, but I expect there will be, and that JLUP is a real leader in pioneering the idea.
Here with JLUP, you can bring ideas to the table, and we have a chance to really play out those ideas in policy by, you know, hosting a symposium on campus dealing with relevant cutting-edge issues, by increasing our technology, where if you look on our webpage, I think our journal is more advanced than any, arguably, in the country. We have a blog on our journal, which gives a chance for students and scholars to share ideas and discuss articles that scholars or students, practitioners, want to post on our webpage. We also have, so it has this interactive feature to it. That's one of the ideas that we want to foster on JLUP, is to build a journal that brings new ideas to the table.
Being on the journal is a lot of work, it really is. It's only one credit, but it kind of reminds me of that LRW credit where you put the most amount of work and again a minimal amount of credits. But at the same time, the experience you gain, the people you meet, and the doors it opens for you, it's so much more valuable than the one credit, and it's definitely worth the time you're going to put in.
It is not the only, but one of the ways in which law students begin as professionals to give back. It's a form of service. It's not service to indigent clients, as is performed in clinics, but it's service to the legal profession. You are making it possible for us, scholars, to make our work available, and helping us to improve the quality of our work and the presentation of our work. And that's a real service to the legal profession, and I think that it's wonderful that law students have that opportunity while they still are students.
I think you get the best of both worlds. You get the rigorous exposure to scholarship that I just talked about. You learn the importance of being rigorous and self-disciplined. But you also get to work on major issues of our time. I mean, I'll be perfectly honest, editing an article about 12th century tort law in Scotland has its limitations, and I did a little bit of that as a law review member. Everything the Journal of Law and Public Policy does is very current, very much on the edge of what's on the front page of the newspaper every day. So I think it's a unique opportunity to not only experience the rigorous scholarship that I have made reference to, but also to learn about issues that are very much determining the shape of the world in which we live.
It's not just, you know, we'll have the 3-9s, the 4-0 members, but we also want people that can bring ideas to the table, and because that's really what pushes the organization forward.
At JLUP, we're looking for the smartest, brightest individuals that are in the incoming 2L class that are willing to work hard and that want to succeed. And if you think you meet that description, please apply. So we'll be looking for you.